gang, how you doing? Jonathan here for Tailhunter Sportfishing, and it's time once again for the Mexican Minute La Paz Video Fishing Report, coming to you from La Paz, Baja, Mexico, and I'm going to cover the fishing action for our Tailhunter Sportfishing fleet for the dates of the 1st through the 7th of June, 2021. Hope wherever you are, you're doing well. Thank you so much for checking in. Let's jump right into it because there's a lot to tell you, and once again, I've got so many photos. Look, you know, last week I told you it was maybe the best week we've ever had of the season. Well, this past week might have been even better. No world records to tell you about, but a lot of big fish. And incredibly, the Dorado are just dominating everything right now. More Dorado than we've ever seen in years. Bigger Dorado than we've ever seen in years. So once again, I'll tell you what, here's how we do it. I'm gonna go ahead and run the fishing gallery. Let the pictures do the talking for you this time. Take a look. Think about that. Listen, the last 2 weeks I've had so many photos, I just can't fit them all in. Great photos, everybody's having a good time. There is nobody not catching fish. Most folks are catching the biggest or more fish than they've ever caught in their lives right now. And the Dorado bite, like I'm telling you, they're stacked up at the north end of town. Now, they're moving around a lot. This is the time when we usually have what I've called a transition time. Cooler water's moving out, warmer waters are moving in, and it's bringing the pelagic species, like the Dorado. We're seeing more marlin, wahoo are out there. We finally got some tuna as well. Don't get too excited about the tuna yet. They pop up and they run away. Everybody gets excited. So tuna, we'll wait and see on that. But the Dorado, I mean, we're talking, you know, normally this time of year, the Dorado are 10, 15 pounds. We get excited if one's a little bigger than that. The Dorado right now are averaging 15 to 30 pounds. These are big, big bulls, as you saw in the photos. And I've got folks who are, they're taking days off because they've got too much fish after a day or two. I mean, their coolers are loaded. They are releasing. You know, everyone wants to know about if we're releasing fish. I'm going to tell you, probably 70% of the fish that are being caught right now, they're releasing it because they've got so much meat with these Dorado. Now, as I said, the Dorado are at the north end of town. They're moving with the Sargasso. The warmer water is starting to move further south. The better fishing has been with our La Paz fleet. Now, if you're familiar with us, we have two different fleets. One is at Las Arenas and fishes around Saravo Island. That's to the southeast of us, about 30, 40 miles. The other fleet we have is our Tailhunter La Paz fleet. We push right out of La Paz and we go north. And that's where the better fishing for the Dorado have been. Now, these Dorado are starting to move further south. They're coming down the channel between Saravo Island and the peninsula around Las Cruces, Punta Mejia, Punta Coyote. That's where the big bite has been on these Dorado. You find the right spot and boom, you know, it might be a slow day. Everybody gets a little frustrated. They tell me, they come back, you know, it was slow. We didn't think anything was happening. And then all of a sudden, late in the day, boom, they find the right spot. They find the right Sargasso patch. And it's one rod, two rods, three rods, four rods. The Dorado are just voracious, and they stack things up. So you just got to hit the right spot. One boat might do a little better than another boat another day, but overall, after 2 or 3 days, everybody's got fish. And these fish are slowly starting to move south. Las Arenas has not seen too many Dorado so far, but we're seeing a few more every single week. So they're starting to move south. And I got a feeling, give it another week or two, and we're going to see a lot more Dorado with our Las Arenas fleet, the one that pushes off the beach over at Muertos Bay. Now, that doesn't mean that Las Arenas, Muertos Bay, Sorovo Island has been bad. We've got Pargo, we've got Cabrilla, we got our first couple of Marlin hookups this week. As I said, there were some tuna hooked up. Not to get excited about that, as I said, they pop up and they run away. So we know they're there, they're just moving too fast. There's Jack Crevel, there's African Pompano, there's regular Pompano, there's, I think I counted about 14 different species that we caught over there with our fleet. So there's no shortage of action, but the waters are starting to get warmer over there. So as we get warmer water around that area, we're going to see fewer of the Pargo, fewer of the Cabrilla, fewer of the Sierra, fewer Amberjack, Yellowtail. We'll start seeing more Wahoo, hopefully more tuna, more billfish, and definitely more Dorado. So that's really, really encouraging. We're excited about what's going on right now. Weather has been perfect. Just the last couple of days, it really did get warmer. We were in the high 80s, low 90s without a lot of humidity, but the last couple days you could really feel the heat coming on. It's running about 95 degrees right now, very, very comfortable. The humidity hasn't increased that much. Water temperatures are real fun, about 82 degrees right now. So if you want to go swimming, scuba diving, snorkeling with us, we can set that up and get you in the water, put your toes in the sand. Anyway, that's a quick wrap up on what's going on. Oh, let me tell you also real quick, just this week they started those direct flights from the United States into La Paz. They tried that during the winter time. They've decided to continue that this summer, and it just started this week. So if you're anywhere near Dallas or Phoenix, there are direct flights on American Airlines right into La Paz. Quick 2.5 hour flight. You're landing at our La Paz International Airport. You're 10 minutes away from their hotel. Boom, you're right there. We got you. You got a cold beer in hand, toes in the sand, ready to go fishing. So check that out. They're going to run these flights until the beginning of September. It's not every day, 2-3 days a week out of Phoenix and out of Dallas if you want a direct flight into La Paz. This is pretty much the first time in about 10 years we've had these flights. So that's going to wrap it up. Thank you for checking in. Thank you for hanging in. I know this is a little longer than normal, but take care. Check with us next week. We'll have a lot more information. And please do us a big favor. If you like what we're doing, if you're enjoying these reports, don't forget to subscribe. Okay, God bless. Take care. This is Jonathan for the Mexican Minute. We'll check back with you next week.